Hello friends, welcome to Programming Concepts. My name is Amit and this is a new course on ASP.NET Core MVC .NET 5, a step-by-step course with Visual Studio 2019. In this course, we will cover what is .NET Core, why should we learn .NET Core, a small discussion whether .NET Core is going to be the future of .NET developers. We will create a sample project of .NET Core MVC from scratch and cover all minute details to get you started. We'll cover dependency injection. And to make it simple, we do not use Entity Framework Core for CRUD operations. By profession, I am a .NET developer. And before actually moving on to this course, I would like to share my real-life scenario which forced me to learn .NET Core, and that might help you to decide whether to opt for .NET Core or not. Our team created a software developed in .NET platform. Most of the clients, in fact, all of the clients were really happy with that software. Until a new prospect came from sales team. And he said, I can't provide you Windows Server. We only have Linux Server. Why you need a Windows Server? It is expensive and I can't approach my management to go for it. Moreover, the last vendor developed similar application and that work on both the platform, Windows and Linux. In my mind, that must be developed in Java, man. Sure, sir, we will figure out some solution. And that's when I said, Microsoft, save me. So when we start exploring options available to fulfill my client requirement, I can see there are lots of options available in the market. I can opt for Node plus Angular, or I can opt for PHP, Python, Java, or any other cross-platform or Linux supporting platform. Give me that option. Apart from that, I can go for .NET Core, where as a .NET developer, the migration is quite easy. Not only this, even though .NET Core is an open source platform, but it is started and managed by Microsoft team. And Microsoft is a big vendor in the information technology world. There are thousands of products available in the market from Microsoft. If I talk about the latest one, MIP, Microsoft Information Production, is very popular. The older one, SharePoint, is extremely popular. So in future, if there is any requirement that your application needs to interact with such technologies, .NET Core being a Microsoft product has definitely some advantages over these technologies, which I have specified in the slide. I would like to add disclaimer here that these are my personal views. Every technologies have their own advantages, but being a .NET developer, it is somehow easier for me to convert from .NET to .NET Core as compared to learning new technologies, which is far from .NET world. Let's continue our discussion with ASP.NET and its limitations. ASP.NET is still a popular web development framework for building web apps on .NET platform. But what's their limitations are? So Windows Phone are nowhere close to Android or iOS. So I guess I don't have to explain this further. Windows desktop apps are reducing day by day, and this is no longer a hidden news. Competition with open source technologies like Node, PHP, Python, etc. make it tough to survive. Dependency on Windows operating system, that's the biggest weakness of ASP.NET. That dependency on Windows operating system to develop and deploy code on IIS only. Also, the dream to create magic in the form of use state in web form, where the intent is to oppose the stateless nature of HTTP to stateful. Although it is really convenient for developer, but in big enterprise application, it is hell for user because size of request increased dramatically because of view states. And to get rid of these limitations, Microsoft came up with ASP.NET Core. ASP.NET Core is the open source version of ASP.NET that runs on macOS, Linux, and Windows. ASP.NET Core was first released in 2016 and is a redesign of earlier Windows-only versions of ASP.NET. Let's see what are the advantages .NET Core has to offer. First is high performance. So Microsoft done a pretty good job in terms of increasing the performance as compared to previous versions of .NET platform. Next is platform independent, and this is a big step taken by Microsoft to make this language available to different platforms, which means in terms of development point of view, you can develop your application in Windows, macOS and Linux. And in terms of hosting point of view, you can host your application on IIS, Apache, Docker, as well as self-hosting in your own process. Next is open source. Finally, Microsoft makes something available to the outside world, which also means more developer communities will join and we can take advantages of their work, and that is directly available from NuGet Package Manager. Next is middleware and dependency injection. This is another powerful concept injected in .NET Core that we will discuss in our upcoming videos. Finally, simplified structure and single framework. That means no app data and app start, global.asax replaced with startup.cs, same controller-based class for Web API and MVC, unlike prior versions of MVC. In our next video, we will try to figure out the answer of two most debatable questions. First, will .NET Core be the future of .NET developers? And will .NET survive against other open source technology giants like Java, Python, Node.js, etc.? Till then, thanks for watching.